Yeah,
I don't want to
trip. Y'all do not do that, because y'all like to go.
Computers and technologies and your phones and your iPads, it's still a library. And you still got to check in and check out, and outside of your school, there's still library. You owe that library book, but you still gonna have to pay it. So, you know, so even, let's say, like, in the future, we have all these technologies, right? And then the power go off, batteries go out, and everything cut off. Everything is gonna be gone, but books is still gonna be there. Am I right? Am I wrong? So your story lives on forever in the book, regardless of, you know, where the future goes. Phones are going to be. So, we got good kids or we got bad kids? Are you good kids?
I'm a good kid.
I'm a good kid. Are you a good kid? You're a good kid? You look like a good kid. So, how old are we in here?
13.
12 teenagers. Are y'all good teenagers? Y'all
listen to my parents.
So at 13 and 14, I was bad. Oh, I was so bad. I was not a good kid. And I really didn't think I was going to make it in school. Honestly, I didn't have. And what did I do? I skip class all the time. I go in the bathroom, hide in there for no reason. Anybody do that? I went shoplifting with my friends and out of control and just comparing and stuff like that. So I didn't think that I was gonna be anywhere in life. Okay. But don't ever let what you're going through as a kid right now, okay, as a teenager. This is the roughest age. I'm gonna tell y'all, there's something that happens to your brain chemically. I don't know what it is. You're at the boys, or you don't want to do school, you don't want to listen to your parents, but enjoy this part of your life because this is the most important part. And so as I grew up, I always stayed in trouble, okay? But surprisingly, I'm 27 now. I am married, I have 2 children. I own a nail salon, a hair salon, and another nail salon back in Maryland. So don't think that whatever trouble y'all gonna do now that y'all can't make it into the future, okay? That you can't be anything out of yourself. Because at 13 and 14, I didn't think, I got locked up. I was in jail at 13 and 14. From 12 to 16, I went to jail. I went to juvie because I didn't listen and I did all this bad stuff. So don't think that at this age that, oh, just because this boy don't like me or I didn't get an A on this test that you're not gonna make it anything. Because I thought I wasn't gonna make it anywhere. I was locked up. They put me in this wilderness program. They put me in a whole bunch of stuff. And I thought I was never going to make it. I thought I was going to grow up and just stay in jail and do all these bad stuff. And I did it. Look at me. I'm lit. I'm on TV. I'm on YouTube. I've been doing all these things and I'm giving back and I have children of my own now. So my son is 9 and my daughter is 4. And, you know, I keep it 100% with my kids. I don't lie to my kids about anything. You know, I talk to them about things that do happen because it's still real life. Okay, things are always going to happen to you, and it's called, you know, sometimes you hit rock bottom. You ever hit rock bottom where you cry, and you just feel like you're not going to make it out of this spot? You're going to get out of it, and then guess what? It's going to happen again, and it's going to happen again, and again, and again. It's just part of life. You're just going to continue hitting rock bottom, but you always remember that you're going to make it past that point, okay? And especially being a teenage girl, it's hard, okay? It's tough. One thing I have to say about being a teenager is do not be a bully. Okay, I joke all the time, I make fun of my friends, but not to a point where I want to hurt their feelings, you know? I'm known as a comedian, okay? I make jokes, I do pranks, you know, I talk about people all the time, but you never want to do it to a point where you want to make someone cry, you know what I'm saying? Jokes go to a point where, you know, girl, what are those? That's cool, you know? Stuff like that is okay, but we don't know what another person is going through at the end of the day. Say, for instance, you make fun of somebody every single day, right? Might make fun of their hair, make fun of their shoes or their clothes, and things like that, and then they go home, they might not even have food in their fridge. Or they might be getting beat by their stepdad, or they're going through all these things as a teenager, and you don't even know that. And so you're making their day harder in class by making fun of them when you're home. And suicide rates are really high in middle school, isn't it? You don't ever want to make somebody go home when they want to hang themselves, kill themselves, or cut themselves. I've met a lot of teenagers while I was a teenager that cut themselves, don't want to hang themselves, that don't want to live anymore because what they go through. But just remember that you want, when you joke and you have fun, make sure that it's just to have fun, okay? Just to laugh. It's okay to laugh. It's okay to make fun of each other to laugh, but not to get to a point where you want to hurt another child or make them feel really, really bad, okay? Or feel at danger. But I don't even know, I'm just rambling. Y'all have any questions? I don't even know what I'm talking about. I'm in a whole speech, so I don't even know what I'm talking about. Hey, girl, we are. So are you the right teacher?
Well, yes, I
have
the right teacher.
So what are y'all writing
about? Right now, with this one, that I've got the nice one. So this one, I've had some different experiences.
Oh, so you guys are writing about your life story.
Not all of
them. No, most of them. Some of y'all. So make sure you don't hide anything about your life story, okay? It's okay. Don't be embarrassed to share things. Don't be, because those struggles are what makes you who you are, okay? So I don't ever hide and say, oh, yeah, no, I never went to jail. I was a perfect kid, you know? No, I wasn't. I grew up poor. I grew up with nothing. I'm the youngest out of 11. So when I grew up, it was 11 of us living in a two-bedroom apartment. And you know, they don't speak English, okay? None of my family knew how to speak English, it was only me. So growing up, I got made fun of. Oh, Ling Ling, oh, shrimp fried rice, oh, egg roll, shrimp egg roll. Oh, you eat dogs, you eat cats. I grew up with all of that, okay? I grew up being the only Asian girl. And when I was locked up, I was the only Asian girl in all Black girl community. Everybody was Black. And I'm used to it. You know what I'm saying? What doesn't kill you, doesn't make you stronger? I don't know. I don't know what makes you stronger. It just makes me not care about what you have to say. Okay? If you know deep down that you're a good person, you know what kind of person you are, no matter what somebody says to you, it will never, ever hurt you. So thank God gave me this, you know, humorous personality. So when people make fun of me, I make fun of them right back. You know? Just do that. So you don't sit inside of you. And the people always say, how do you be a real cool person? You know, I don't talk about other people because I talk to them in front of their face, okay? So even with the jokes, like, for instance, if I, if I make fun of you in your face, I'd be like, oh, girl, you ashy, or, you know, you're a dust girl, or your breath stink, I'm telling you in front of your face, even though it's in a joking way. When I go home and I go to sleep, I sleep real good because I already said it to your face. I don't have to go behind your back and say something to you now. Okay? So just be straight up with people. That's what's wrong with girls. We're going to kiss you back, right? And do all that big stuff. You might do all that big stuff. You'll go out and you'll learn about it. But I'm so happy that y'all read the book. It's really exciting.
So y'all have any questions for her?
Yeah, ask me one.
I mean, she's writing a book. She's on TV. She owns her own business. And she came from some of the same backgrounds as some of you come from. And you don't have any questions that you want to ask.
I see your hand, girl. Come on, Tatiana.
She has.
Tatiana, come on.
Do you have any questions?
Come on, come ask your question.
Yes, they
find you.
Oh, thank you. I'm trying to find an outfit that covered my tits. This is hard to say.
She's gonna come ask a question. Maybe that'll get them warmed up.
I know, get warmed up. I'm right. I'm not a mean one. Hi, baby. What's your question?
So my question is, how were your challenges during your entrepreneurship through your business?
Can you say it one more time so they can hear you? Can y'all hear her?
Say it.
Be louder.
Say it louder.
I said, what were What were some challenges
during her entrepreneurship for her?
Okay, my challenges is
haters! Haters! So I had a couple haters, you know. I don't want to say no names, but, you know, they try to find stuff and be like, oh, this not legal, she ain't got this, she ain't got that. If I don't know if anybody watched the show, but, you know, somebody tried, you know, drag me and my business down and say, oh, I don't have this and I have that. So everything you must do in life, keep it legal, okay? So if you're gonna do something right, do it through paperwork, get it legalized, do it the right way. Because if you do it the right way, then can't nobody throw nothing in your face, okay? So, excuse me, I don't got what? I don't got a license? Oh, here you go, boop! I got a license. I got this paperwork for this and that. But that was my biggest challenge, was that, you know, the haters, one of the haters was trying to say that I didn't have, you know, the correct paperwork for this or for that, and that I didn't legally own something. But, yeah, I have my paperwork, so she's gonna say nothing. That's it. You guys got questions? Yes, baby.
Why do I want to be a businesswoman?
Okay. Who has allowances? Y'all getting money? Yeah. Now, who's saving money? Good. Who buying talkies? Even as your age now, or even younger, you get allowances. You save this money. What are you saving for?
College.
Food.
More food.
More food. Who eat all that? PlayStation. Okay. Good job. So you're when you get these amount of money from allowances, you're saving. But you're saving for something bigger that you can buy, that you can purchase. But as you get older, and you have kids and you have children, you're going to want to save to buy into a business. Because a business will make you more money, right? So the business will make you more money. So this is why I have businesses, because I do it for my children, okay? So when I get older and my son or my daughter become 18, and whether they don't want to go to college or school may not be for everybody. Mm-hmm. And, you know, life becomes a challenge when you get older because you don't know where you're going to work. You don't know what you're going to do. And I don't want my children to be homeless. And my biggest fear is for my children to struggle the way that I did struggle. Me and my husband, that's my husband over there. Say, hey, Ram!
What's up, everybody?
So, we struggle to get to where we are, you know, as an adult. So I want to have these businesses so I can save money, so I can pay for my son's school. I can pay for my daughter's nail salon or a hair salon or whatever it is that she wants to do. You build these businesses so you can save more money, so you can give to your children. When I die, I want to give my children something. You know, I want to leave them, whether it's a home, a car, a business. I don't want to just die and leave them nothing, and then they're like, mommy ain't leaving me with nothing. And then your children have to struggle. So that's why, you get allowances, you save to get what you want. And you keep doing that for the rest of your life, because, you know, without a foundation or without a business, without money, you're just going to be on the streets. And you never want to be on the street begging nobody for money. And I never like asking anybody for money. Whether it's a friend, an aunt, an uncle, a friend, a relative, getting your own money, saving your own money is always better than having to ask somebody else for money. Okay? So save them little pennies and stop buying all the Takis, buy one bag of Takis a week. Okay, what's your question, baby?
Yeah. Oh, what is your nationality?
Oh, I am Vietnamese. Hello, Ling Ling again. For your mama and for your auntie. So that's what I am. But I'm Vietnamese, but I was raised with all black people. So as far as like my friends, my business, I don't know if you ever checked out my nail salon, but I have a lot of black nail techs that work for me. I like to break the cycle of, what do you call that? The racism?
Is it racism?
Not racism. Like, yeah, close to that, but not really racism. Like a
stereotype.
There you go. I want to break stereotypes, because they always say, oh, the Asian ladies do the nails. Why are there no black ladies doing nails? So when I open up my nail salon, I want it to be diverse. I want it to break up stereotypes. So not only, you can be any race. There can be purple, you can be pink, you can be blue. You can come work for me, honey. We do the nail for you. So at my shop, we have black girls, we got Puerto Ricans, and we got me, the Asian girl. I had another Asian girl, so, you know, breaking the stereotype. So if you want to do nails, you can do nails. But if you want to go to school, then stay in school. Anybody else have questions? Yeah, baby.
The challenges that you faced when you become you think back on them now.
Oh, of course. I think back on my all time.
And you know, sometimes I miss it. It wasn't easy for me because I was transferred from different group homes to different facilities. So I would go to like a lockdown facility for 3-4 months, and I would meet a bunch of different girls and then staffs. You build a relationship with people, and then they will transfer me, and I'll leave again and leave again and leave again. But now that I sit back, now that I'm older and I think about it, like, I appreciate those things that I got to go through, because not everybody got to go through those things and experience it. I got to go through like therapeutic stuff and learn how to work with my feelings and realize where is my anger coming from or why I do the things that I do. So it was tough, but it was fun. And then I think about it, you know, I miss it. I do miss it. I miss girls or just everything that we went through. I wasn't always, I was never a good kid, but.
Where's your shop located?
My shop is 5046 Old National Highway. Who knows where Old National is? You know Old National is? It's a hood, but it's a little bit nicer. It's not that bad. We have a nice little shop. It's in the beginning before you get deep down in there. You know what? Okay. So, I was 16, so I left out of the wilderness program. So I went back to high school. Now, I did not finish high school, and that's something that I regret, okay? I dropped out like a senior. How stupid, right? What an idiot. I dropped out in 12th grade, and I should have continued, because the years after high school, it goes by so fast. It's just like, why did I drop out? I could have been finished. But because I didn't want to go to school, my mom said, oh, you don't go to school, you're going to do nails. So at 16, I started doing nails. Now, what made my nails become really... how can you say successful is because I didn't just sit there and do regular nails. I try to do different things every time. So I just, instead of me just sitting there, oh, I ain't never gonna do nothing with my life. I ain't finished school. I'm just gonna sit here and do nails. I started perfecting my nails. Started doing fun things, trying to find different ways to make more money. And nail is a hustle, okay? Nail is a hustle. Nails is not a job. You don't get paid by the hour. It's a hustle. You don't have to learn how to sell. You have to learn how to get that person to get more done to the nails. You have to learn how to ways to get them to come back, build a relationship, have a personality. So nail isn't just something that you sit there, oh, home. You done, pay my money. No, it's like, honey, you want a quicker deal, $5 more. You upsell, it's all about upsell, it's about hustling. You put in your hours. I used to work 6 days a week for me to get to right here, for me to buy the home or my house and stuff. I wouldn't see my kids for days. Before I moved to Atlanta, I used to work 6 days a week, 10 to 12 hours a day, so maybe 14 hours a day. I wouldn't get home till 1 o'clock in the morning because I was too busy hustling. Then that's when I had to sit back and really, you know, get too greedy with the money and really sit down and have time for my family. But it's a hustle, just like hair. Hair is a hustle. So it's either you're gonna go to school and you're gonna get a career that's gonna pay you a good salary and pay you like $50, $60 an hour, or you're gonna do nails or hair. That's a hustle. You have a hustle mentality. Like, if you're selling candies and chips right now in high school, you probably won't be a hustler. Dang, I'm not going to force you to go to college because that's not going to be for you. But if you're writing them essays and you get A's and A's and A's and 4.0s, oh, yeah, you go to college. No? But it's not for everybody. I wouldn't force it on everybody. So if you're selling them Takis and Snicker bars and them Twix, you're going to be a hustler. Anybody else got a question? Pretty good?
Anybody else?
You guys, question for me, teacher?
I do have a question. I know a lot of them know you for Love and Hip Hop. How did you get that experience? And beforehand, Sewing Club. Miss Pena's asking for y'all. So Sewing Club, you need to go to Sewing.
Oh, y'all be sewing? Let me get me clothes.
They have made some things.
Oh, okay, you can make me some.
Dr. Derrico, please call the main office. Dr. Derrico, please call the main office. This year.
Bye, girls. Be good.
Okay, we're going to talk about that. So how did you get the opportunity to be on Love & Hip Hop?
First off, y'all not even supposed to watch Love & Hip Hop. Y'all is too young. It's like, Now, when Love & Hip Hop reached out to me about a year before, It took me a year to say yes, only because the show was so negative as far as family and stuff like that. And I have a real family. You know what I'm saying? I have a real husband and children, and I didn't want the show to mess up my family and where we came from. And so it took me a whole year to say yes. So I was just trying to see what conjuring stuff that they had going on. Because, you know, they want to make you look bad before they make you look good. So, I mean, they made me look real loud. And it made me look like I had no neck. But I got a neck in person. No, you see that neck? I told you I got a neck. I was on the other ring. And you want to fight? I got no neck on TV. I was like, turn you over. Videos on Vine and YouTube, and if y'all subscribe to my YouTube video now, you know I've always been the comedian before then. I see you, baby. No question. So before that, you know, I was already popping before I loved hip hop. So you know, things are only gonna get better, and you know, I really didn't like how they portrayed me. Yeah, it made me seem like I want to fight everybody.
They did.
I didn't want to fight everybody. See, I think I'm just too real for it because. If you say something about me, I do want to fight. That's really bad. But then at the same time, we're women. We have to learn how to stand our ground. So I'm not telling y'all to be out here and fight. But if there's somebody to try y'all, then never punk down to anybody. Don't ever, ever, ever let nobody punk you, especially if they think you're weaker. Or maybe, oh, she a nerd. She ain't going to do nothing. For me, all my life is, oh, she Asian. She ain't about that life. Oh, you got the wrong Asian today, boo. You got the wrong one. So fighting is not always where to go. But never back down to anybody. Never, ever let anybody punk you. You understand me? Because at the end of the day, it's your pride. Okay? It's you who you are. Never, ever let nobody talk to you any type of way that you wouldn't talk to them like that. Okay? So I live life how if I treat you a certain type of way, I expect for you to treat me that type of way. You know, I'm very happy. I'm always bubbly. I might be a little bit loud all the time, but I'm always bubbly, and I always want the best for other people. So I'm not going to be mean to you, and I'm not going to hurt your feelings. So if you do that to me, then it's on. It's on, but I'm just saying, you know, you go through life going that way. Just don't ever let nobody punk you. And always seek for guidance, because you guys are still young. It's not the way to go. Okay, so you guys have your teacher here. I'm pretty sure you have many more counselors and teachers, her, all the adults over here. You know, you reach out to them, get help from them, talk to them. Don't keep things bowled up inside, because that's what makes you crazy, okay? And you don't want to be a crazy kid, okay? Because 13, 14, y'all have emotional problems, and then you don't keep it inside. Don't keep it bowled up, because that's when you start plotting, and then you see you on the investigation channel and stuff like that. Don't do that. Make sure you talk to somebody, and it's okay. I'm pretty sure all the teachers here, they wouldn't work for kids if they didn't like kids. You know, I don't really like y'all kids. That's why I don't like kids. I really don't know. I don't have patience. So I come talk to y'all here once and then here and there. That's fine. But, you know, these people are really dedicated to working with your age group and working with school. That's why they're here. So make sure you just reach out to them.
No, I noticed on the show we didn't see, like, we saw a lot of other people's kids. Is it a decision that, okay, you can decide that you want to include your family or not include your family? Do they give you the option?
I think they give you the option. I didn't mind, because my kids are what I represent. I don't hide my kids. Y'all see my kids on Instagram. I always post my kids. A lot of people hide the kids. I hide your kids. I hide your wife. I don't know why. I hide the kids. But I'm probably, you know, now I don't let my kids watch it. You know, I don't let him watch it. If he sneaks to watch it, I mean, that's on him, but we don't sit there and watch it. I've never even watched it before I got on the show. But I don't let him, you know. But I don't hide them. These are my children. I'm proud of them. My son is 9. He's as worse as me. He has a YouTube, too. I don't even try to watch it because I don't even know what he's talking about. He's worse than me. Like, he has comebacks and his jokes are worse than mine. And I have a daughter who's 4. Her name's Kamaya. We call her Juice. You can follow the Instagram at Juice and Jay. We got a little sister or something.
Put me on. Any more questions?
I'm trying to sit like you, but I think my butt is big. Y'all see my toes up here? My toes are sliding to the front. Like, oh, wait a minute. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I want to be trying. you can't get nothing done in life if you, you know, you don't get up and do it. You can do whatever you want to do. If you don't want to do it, you ain't going to do it. That's it. That's all I can tell you about that. If you want something bad enough, you're going to go over there and do it. So if you don't want it, you ain't going to do it. You're just going to make excuses. You want to do something, oh, I'm tired. Oh, I ain't got no money this week. Oh, my mama said no. You're just going to lie and make up stuff. If you want to do something, you're going to get up and you're going to do it. But do positive things.
Now, do they film you from like?
No, mm-mm.
They don't film you
all
the time?
That's a waste of camera time. Yeah. But this, I think I want to get into stand-up comedy.
I think you should.
I think you
should. That was going to be my question.
Yeah, I don't think the reality show is really for me. It's too negative. I have more positive things that I like to share. I don't think they really even try to touch any positivity about me. But I don't think I have enough drama for, you know, reality style. I think I want to do more acting and more comedy and stand-up comedy. So 2018 is what I'm pushing for, stand-up comedies, and just probably get into, you know, comedy movies and stuff like that. Get a Netflix series. What's up, Monique? Hey, my loves.
You should, really, because you were great.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Now, in your story that you're writing, are you going to share like the details of the things that you did?
Oh yeah. So in the story that I'm writing, it's gonna start off when I was 3 years old. So if you you guys can read it and you'll learn more about my teenage life, what my struggle was in middle school and high school, and you know all the placements that I was locked up at. You guys get to learn my struggles. I had a lot of struggles with, you know, fitting in, coming from an Asian family, never getting along with my mother, my family never understanding me. Racism, and also boys. I had boy problems.
No.
When you got boy problems?
That computer laughs. You need to go to the
You never in love, baby. Just remember that. You never in love. I went through so many boyfriends. I thought I was in love every time. I would love him so much. We're gonna be together forever. No, you ain't with them.
Okay, three boyfriends.
Okay. Well, thanks for having me, you guys. I am getting ready. I gotta go meet up with some other people.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, girls. Come give me hugs. Come on.
Come on.